Since the early 1960s, we've been launching people into space. Those first people, of course, were men. But shortly after the first men launched, Valentina Tereshkova of the Soviet Union launched into space as well. It took almost another 20 years for a woman to launch into space, and that was as a mission specialist on an early space shuttle mission. In the United States, as the space shuttle program began in the 1970s, NASA realized it was time to include women in the program as well. And in 1978, it brought its first six women into the astronaut corps. And those women trained right alongside all of their mission specialist colleagues. Now, the designation of mission specialist is largely for scientists, not for pilots and commanders of missions. Those paths remain blocked for women for a little bit longer, until military academies began bringing women in and allowing them to become test pilots and aircraft pilots. So after the women in the astronaut corps began their training, it was in 1984 that Sally Ride prepared to be the very first American woman to fly into space. And on her first mission, while she didn't think her accomplishment was all of that important, there were hundreds and thousands of people carrying signs at the launch that said, "Ride, Sally, Ride." There were t-shirts and buttons. And the experience of going to that launch inspired many, many, many women over. In fact, it inspired a very particular woman who was running for vice president at the time, and that was Geraldine Ferraro. And when Sally Ride learned just how much of an impact that mission had had on Miss Ferraro, it really altered the way she thought about what she had done. And then Sally became a voice for inspiration as well. She began looking to younger women and inspiring them as well, starting educational programs that would inspire young girls to get into science, technology, and engineering fields. And she went on with that throughout her entire life, inspiring young women. And every single one of the early women astronauts has gone through something very similar, inspiring young women to get involved in spaceflight. And while women advanced their careers and became pilots and commanders in the 1990s of space shuttle missions, women like Peggy Whitson eventually went on in the early 2000s to be a commander of the International Space Station. And much to her fortune, she got to greet the commander of a space shuttle mission who was also a woman up in space. So when Pam Melroy and Peggy Whitson shook hands aboard the International Space Station, it marked a new era for women in space. A new era for women in space had begun to include new faces, new backgrounds, new specialties, and new cultures. And so women like Anousheh Ansari brought her own Iranian background to space, as have women since her as well. Now we have women doing spacewalks together and going into space with potentially new careers in front of them. And now we may even have the first woman to land on the moon in the astronaut corps. So as we move forward with going back to the moon and Mars, we know that women will be in the driver's seat as those missions are completed. And we, women, can be a part of spaceflight dreams as well.